What's up, guys? Dane and Big Schweds here. We are down at Engine Room Woolwee, down to hit some shoulders. Great setup down here at Engine Room Woolwee. Haven't been down here, guys. Make sure you pop down, check it out. Gonna hit some delts, throw some weight around, show you guys how we go through our weight sessions, tips, tricks, so you guys can take away a fair bit from it. Now we're gonna run you through our pre-workout mix. So we've got some goodies here. Now, Dax and I, first thing every morning, we have already consumed our hydration, so electrolytes, and our pure carbs. So we have that half an hour to an hour before training.
We like to consume the hydration, obviously, first thing in the morning, because we are both morning trainers, usually even way earlier than this, 4:30 in the morning. Very, very important going into a workout in the first thing in the morning to make sure you're properly hydrated. Obviously, big cardinal sin not to train on a carbohydrate. Very, very simple. Your pure carbohydrates, 1 to 2 scoops. 1 scoop will give you 20 gram. I usually shoot for about 2 to 3. So it's hitting, trying to hit 60 grams, especially when I'm training with Dane. All right, so we've already consumed that. We're about 45 minutes deep into that. I'm gonna mix our pre-workout mix. And this is, I usually don't load it too high. You can see on the back of the pre-workout tub as well, because of the TGA readings, I usually say mix it in a liter order. You do not need to do that.
Yeah.
This is the pump liquid, or liquid pump, right? One of the best.
The OG when it comes
non-stimulant pump formulas you consume. You can consume. So we hit one capful.
The finest.
Right, straight in. Mixes very easy.
It's a bit of bartender.
Yeah, sure. Don't shot it. Just mix it in your pre-workout.
Yeah.
Dane's opting for another non-stim now. It's not necessary that you need to use both, but it's obviously
one. Free.
Oh, we've got the pro. Sorry, I thought we had. Oh, wow. There we go. I thought it was the amps.
See?
All right, there we go. I need some stimulants. So we've opted for the Perform Stim Pro. I was thinking, how much pump do you want here?
Wow, yeah.
How many scoops do you want here?
I'll go a scoop and a half. I'm trying with you.
I'm just going to go one. The Perform pre-workout, not the amped. The non-stim liquid,
right?
And we're going to go for about 3 to 5 grams of creatine.
So creatine monohydrate.
What does creatine do, Dane?
So creatine is going to help, obviously, with strength and power. It's going to help with muscle endurance, so we can train harder for longer. Sure. Also, recovery and lean muscle.
Form pre, our pump liquid, or liquid pump, non-stim, 3 to 5 grams of creatine and about 300 ml of water. You ready?
Perfect.
All right, let's go.
Mix. Two flicks of the wrist.
All right, so today we're gonna focus on shoulders and traps, but we're not, what you're gonna notice with this workout, we're not gonna go super heavy. We're gonna go somewhat heavy, but focus more on the intensity of training. Basically what we've gone over with our last podcast, it doesn't always need to be super heavy, but you need to train with intensity, and you'll see that today. That's the main goal for today's workout.
Intensity. Pumps, focus, intensity, blood flow.
We're gonna start with upright barbell row, yeah?
Yep.
Yes.
Yeah. The city is up in the madness. Yeah. The people is giving the damage. Yeah. They turn into animal savage. So rhinos and hippos and mammoths.
This is somewhat some of the hardest part of the workout, putting this thing on top of the bar.
Yeah.
Maddie. Maddie, what's doing? Let's get the plastic ones happening down here. We are 10 aside now, plus the bar, what's a 20 kilo, 18 kilo. First working set after our 2 warm-up sets. We're gonna shoot for 10 to 12. Elbows nice and high. Working on the upright row for the front delts and more show traps. The hero was coming, I'm locked in. You know that I'm winning, I'm top 10. You know that I came from the dark pen. You want it, you get it, you drop dead. The rebel who came from the bottom. My enemies know that I got it. I'm planting my seeds in gardens. Then watching them. So the reason we've started on this exercise, focusing obviously more so on the traps, is I guess when you're coming into a workout, instead of just going, all right, we're going to start with side raises or a press. Most people hit a press.
Heavy press, yeah.
Yeah. Work out what your weakest part is on that body part, right? If we're doing shoulders, there's so much to it. It's probably more so our traps.
Yeah.
I'd say me and Dane
is more so our traps. So we're going to use all the energy at the start of the workout to hit traps first. And then we're going to work probably more re-delt, but I'll continue to talk about that later. So hit the traps first where we need to try and build up the most. And then we go down to our weak, our stronger body part.
Always weakest
towards
area
the end of the
first.
Workout. Exactly right.
Weakest area. You're the freshest. You got the most energy. That way you can pound it straight away. Nice. Good. See, Dax's reps too, guys. Nice control. Not just throwing weight.
The greatest was always in my plans. Battle the kid is white flag. Not on my level where I stand. Got it, I'm shooting the hot hand. Out of the gym, I was locked out. I failed, the kid was a dropout. I changed the game and it's up now. The city they need me is clear now.
Alright, so
chill out.
Last set's gonna be a bit heavier.
A little bit heavier.
We're gonna shoot for 6 to 8 to 10. All shit stops when the shirt comes off, I think.
That's it.
But as I said, I think personally for years, I've struggled with having strong traps. So I found by starting directly with it like this has helped a lot. We did say we're not working some like too heavy. This is somewhat heavy to probably most people, but we should have no problems getting this up.
Let's go.
All right.
Big set, big set.
That's a lot better now. I thought I'd just sit back.
Big set, let's go.
Sandman, I could tap dance through the energy blast. Run flat, never pop your orbit. I keep energy in storage. I see spinning the globe, my fingertip itch. If I could pluck the...
So that's first exercise in under 7 minutes, roughly. So,
got me there, the 20s.
Really no excuse to take 15, 20 minutes per exercise.
Yeah, how do you see, guys? We're still moving through it pretty steady.
Cool.
You know, Dax does a set, I go a set.
All right, so second exercise. Once again, a lot of people will lack the rear delt, and it's very forgotten about. So what we've gone from our weakness, from our traps, we're working the rear delt here, and we're going to try and make that nice and round so you get that 3D look.
Yeah.
So like I said, most people, your compounds, side raises, right? No one really will struggle with your compounds and in your side raise. Most people will do it. But now we're working re-delts. Okay, I'll show you how we're going to do it. This is so many exercises to do it. So I want you to keep this line here. I want you to keep the dumbbells in line. So you're staying in the line of the bottom of
the bench.
The bench. And we're going to work up, light up, slow. We're going to squeeze the re-delts here. So all pressure when you re-delt here.
Quick hit. Look at the wrist. Let's look at your body. I shake it and shit. I'm shit. Big fish in a small pond. Godzilla with a boot on.
Notice too, guys. It's not my back or my traps doing the work. It's elbows.
That's it.
Elbows up. And squeeze. Squeeze and re-delt. Let it hang.
That's
so it's not a row back. That's a row up and out.
Exactly. Dang. At the end of that.
Yep.
Change it to if someone was going to hit more of a back part of that exercise to show the difference.
Yep. So difference, guys. So again, right, if you watch, re-delt. If you want to hit more of your back, right, more of a neutral group, and it would be
exactly
a little bit more of a row movement. So see the difference. I'll do a few.
Yep.
So row.
Rhomboids.
If we're here,
yep.
All right, elbows a bit more out in front.
We've dealt perfect. We've dealt. Exactly right. Ooh. Excellent.
Shit. So if you can see, guys, right here, rear delt. Little small muscle. Don't have to go heaps heavy, because otherwise if you go heaps heavy, your back will start to take over the movement. Then you're going to go from rear delts onto back. When we're not doing back today, we're doing rear delts.
We're getting warm now, so we don't really have to muck around too much.
Once you're warm, guys, No real need, you know, one or two feeler sets. What I mean by that, get a weight, hit 12 reps. If you find it's a bit easy, then you can just rip straight in.
Don't compromise the technique. I step into your lawn, turn skyscrapers into croutons. Woo! Hit the button going high speed. Need a
megaphone to announce me. I move through the pygmies in the top pick. Feel that. As Dax was saying before too, guys, with shoulders, everyone always aims for shoulder pressing to build big shoulders. If you want to make your shoulders round, give it that 3D look. Always focus on your rear delt, side delt, then move into your pressing later on. Really good way. For myself, I know I do that. Plenty of side delts, plenty of rear delts. And you'll notice over time, more 3D look. A lot of people focus on fronts, but that gets hit a lot when you're doing pressing, so chest. So always focus on the sides and rears. Sit back, better breathe. Look around and they looking at me. Tiptoe still never defeat. Push button never needed a key. I see they ain't ready for me. Hot boy still 100 degrees. I cross eyes and I dotted the T's. D&D till I leave in peace. The people is giving the damage. Come on, push. The people is giving the damage.
Stay there. I don't know if you can see this. Can you see that steam come off his back here?
Oh. Oh,
you can, hey. Doesn't this take dude's me. Always hot.
Doesn't take me long.
It's so hot. It's not even hot yet.
Oh, man. I'm roasting.
We're going to do a drop set.
Yep.
Something that we've talked previously on our podcast as well. He's going to do 25.
Yep.
Drop it down to 12.5s.
Really good technique to add more intensity into your workouts, but also push more blood to the muscle, so more growth. So we'll aim for as many, we think as many as we can on each set.
Absolutely.
Till absolute failure. Break down the muscle, tear it down.
Failure, failure, failure. Now, yeah. You get to 7.5, you could probably do 1,000, but we're gonna go no more than 15 now.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Here you go. Two more now, two more. One more. Drop. Come on. Okay. Three. Two more, go two more. One more. Nice.
Cool.
Beautiful.
Cool. They're the sets, guys. Intensity. Talk about it all day long. When it comes to training, intensity. During those sets, you'd be surprised how many more you have in the tank. Like even that last set, I'm like three more ducks, like four more, five more. Bang, 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 you've got more. Push.
Two more, two more.
Come on.
Up. One more.
Up. Good. Four. Three. Up. Up. Good. Four. Up. Three. Two more. One more. Good. They're the sets, guys, as we talk about. Intensity. Intensity. Feel them rear delts. Full of blood.
I haven't got much to add to that. It felt great. All right. Okay, so third exercise.
Third.
Now we're starting on the side delts, focusing on the medial delt. So without getting too technical, you've got three parts of the head, of the shoulder, your front, your medial, and your rear. So far, we've only really hit the rear. We've worked more of the traps. Now we're gonna hit the medial. Okay, so let's go. Okay, slow, slow. Good. Got two more. One more. Okay, good, first set. Let's go straight away into it. Okay, so a couple of ways you side raise for me. I like to keep my elbows nice and slightly bent. Danger was absolutely perfect as well.
Yeah, a few different ways, guys, when not just one way to skin a cat, hey, for the old saying. Good. Good. One thing you'll notice too, guys, here with Dax is he's leading from the elbows, okay? Which is gonna allow maximum tension on the side delt. Now, if you're just going like this to get them up, which many of you maybe be doing, is you're taking a side delt exercise to a trap exercise.
Exactly.
So you'll find for years or months you're training your side delts and you're like, oh, I still look like a shut umbrella. That's because you're using your traps and you'll be walking around like this. So make sure lock traps down and push out. A little key as well for me that I like to focus on is I feel like that my knuckles, just in my head, are going along the ground and I'm trying to hit the sides of the room. So I'm trying to actually not bring it up, I'm trying to push out.
Yeah.
Good. Good.
The city is up in the madness. The people is giving the damage. It turned into animal savage. So rhinos and hippos and mammoths. The hero is coming, I'm locked in. You know that I'm winning, I'm top 10. You know that I came from the dark pit. You want it, you get it, you drop dead. The rebel who came from the bottom. My enemies know that I got it. I'm planting my seeds in garments. I'm watching them sprout and harvest.
Okay, last set.
Here we go.
Big drop set. Bang, failure, 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 failure. You're not a failure, but you are on this. You will be.
This is the one time you can be a failure, eh? Nah, that one's a failure. Oh, come on, here we are, mate.
Battle the kid, it's white flag. Land on my level where I stand. Got it, I'm shooting the high hand. Out of the gym, I was locked out. I failed, the kid was a dropout. I changed the game and it's up now. The city that need me is clear now.
Come on.
The people is giving the damage. The people is giving the Sandman, I can tap dance through the energy blast. Run flat, never pop your orbit. I keep energy and storage.
Nice.
Oh my god. Oh.
See what we mean by intensity? 7M.5s, you couldn't get even one more rep out, which was exactly what we're going for. Yeah, wipe yourself up, you're dead.
We're in training, sweating, obviously hydration, electrolytes. Very important, especially now coming into the warmer weather. Training, cardio every day, make sure we stay hydrated. Train harder for longer, stay hydrated, keep the pumps.
We've worked a little bit of our front delt, more so traps. We've hit our rear delt. Okay, I've got a back workout tomorrow, so I'm gonna be hitting a little bit of rear delt as well. We'll just hit medial delt with the sides. Now we're gonna do a compound press, which is gonna hit, obviously, all over your shoulder, but more so medial the front. So Dan will show me the machine we're gonna hit now. I was gonna do dumbbells, but I feel like we're so fatigued.
Yeah, how are you feeling? That shoulder press machine?
Yeah, we're gonna do shoulder press machine. And we're just gonna go very, very berserk and keep it high intensity on that. And then finish with some shrugs for traps.
Perfect. Let's keep it going. All right, guys. Next exercise. So as we touch base on, upright rows, rear delts, side delts. And then we're gonna use a bit of a compound exercise. Hit a little bit more front delt as well, the whole shoulder. So we're just going to aim for what we want to do here, Dax. What are you feeling?
We'll just keep shooting for just keep at shooting. Least, yep. You know, 10 to 12 to 15. 12. The shoulder, like a compound movement, is what you'd call the meat and potatoes of muscle growth for that given body part, okay? So like I said, a lot of people will walk in to do shoulders and I'll start with the press.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with that. I just feel because when you're working shoulders, you want to hit the three heads before you hit the compound movement. That's how I believe and how I've always trained. Like I said, there's no right or wrong, and Dane's the same as well. So if you haven't done it like that, maybe this video is going to show you a way to do it and see if it works for you.
If I could pluck the earthquake hit, look at the wrist, look at your body, I shake it and shift. Big fish in a small pond, Godzilla with a boot on. I step into your lawn, turn skyscrapers into croutons. Hit the button going high speed, need a megaphone to announce me. I move through the pygmies and the top pick, gotta pick please. Sit back, better breathe deep. Look around and they looking at me. 10 toes still never defeat. Push button, never need a key. I see they ain't ready for me. Hot boy still 100 degrees. I cross eyes and I got it to tease. E&D till I leave in peace. The people is giving them damage.
One more exercise. We're gonna just work on traps, yeah?
Yep.
Okay.
Traps. The old trapezius.
Oh. Yeah, I'm dying in the ass, but I've got it. All right. So
we're here, guys. Bit of trap time.
The last exercise of the shoulder workout. I have never used this machine. It's very interesting, but I can see how it can already work for traps. So we're going to whack the plates across here.
Yep.
And you're going to stand in front.
Yep.
And we're just going to do the
same. You can stand like this way, or you can even go this way.
Yeah, okay.
Oh.
They ain't going to fit. Mate, that's not going to fit with Dane's ass.
Yeah. All
right.
Go this way.
Yeah?
Yep.
Okay, cool. All right, let's
load it up. You guys, after doing shoulders, I just find it just puts the icing in the cake. What do you reckon, Dax?
Absolutely.
Tapes everything off. Rep range?
Same.
10 to 12.
15. I feel like this would be pretty light to get through, but let's just get the movement up. Maybe not. It's not that easy, I don't know.
Not.
Slide down, squeeze that.
See how with last set we did 5 hold at the tops, and then once you do that, 5 just all out reps. Another good little technique to finish it off.
Absolute Ooh. Cracker.
In the engine room tomorrow morning, you see a pair of delts laying around or traps. Throw us a message. All right, guys, so that is a wrap. Shoulders and traps in the books. Absolutely crashed. So guys, with that workout, just to touch base on it, upright rows, straight into rear delts, went into sides, then we went into a compound shoulder exercise, just to polish off the delts, and then finished with some traps. So guys, if you have a little bit out of that video, obviously we'll continue to do a lot more content for you guys. Obviously we'll cover all muscle groups in the future. If you've got any questions too, make sure you comment on our post, pop in sore, ask, you know, message myself, Dax, Aria. Even if you want the workout, guys, obviously we'll have it up there for you. But if you guys want it, we can send it through to you. And we hope you got something out of it too, like little takeaways, guys. Just make sure when you're coming into the gym, having a crack, bringing that intensity, as you've seen with Dax and I, like, well, a couple of key exercises brought the intensity, and I'm cooked. I can't even hold my shoulders up, so...
Yeah, the whole idea behind, obviously, what we're filming is just to help educate people. So if you guys are getting something out of this, then we're winning. And that's the whole reason behind it. We've been training for many years, so for us, it's just another workout, but we're just trying to share with you guys, hoping to get something out of it. Obviously, we enjoy what we do. We love it.
Passionate about it.
And obviously, we want questions out of this. We want you guys to ask.
Yeah.
How can I perform this? What should I do with this? And like I said, shoot us a message on our social media, our personal Instagrams, Facebook, whatever, or best pop in store, and we'll show you. In regards to the training intensity, the weights that we use, and the supplements that we use pre-workout, it all links in with each other.
It does.
And it has a purpose behind it. So I hope you guys enjoyed it as much as we did. And like I said, hit us up, get back to us, drop a message, even on the YouTube link below.
See you next time. Thanks, guys.